Hello everyone, welcome to ThemeWinter. Today's video is all about WP Eventin, a WordPress plugin for events, conferences, tickets and whatnot. Before starting the tutorial, I'm assuming you already have installed WP Eventin in your WordPress website. In case if you still need to install it, please get it from the WordPress plugin directory. Now let's dive into the tutorial with creating a new speaker. In order to create a speaker, the first step is to click on the speaker tab from the WP Eventin menu. After that, fill up the information like speaker's name, designation, email, speaker's profile summary and social link. I'm showing you just a single social profile. Exact same way, you can add other social link as many as you want. Don't forget to add a speaker's photo. Well, if you are an organizer, you can add a company logo. If you want to add a company website link, you need to upgrade to the WP Eventin Pro. So far we have created a speaker profile. In the same way, you can add multiple speakers for your event. Before checking the speaker's profile, let's create some schedule for the speaker. In order to add a speaker's schedule, we'll now go to the schedule and then add new tab. I already have created some schedule and now I'm creating one more for you. Starting with adding a title, move to the date, then weekday. After that, come to the schedule list and add a topic, starting and ending time and location. You can add multiple speakers for the same topic. Lastly, add a schedule summary. Now, if needed, you can add schedule 2 with the add button and then fill up the necessary information as needed. It's time to see how our speaker's profile looks like. Doesn't it look good? Well, WP Eventin has two more pro style for the speaker's single page. Let's explore them from the ThemeWinter website. We already have experience on speaker's single page. Now, here, this is our second style for the speaker's details. And the third style is here. You can change this template from the WP Eventin settings menu. In order to do that, please go to WP Eventin, after that click on settings. Under the general tab, you will find the options. From the drop-down menu, select your template, after that finally save it. ThemeWinter team is bringing a lot more style for you in upcoming day, so stay with us. At this time, we are going to explore style for multiple speakers from the ThemeWinter website. Now, here's the first style for the multiple speakers, and this style is completely free. Moving to the next, we have two more style, speaker list and speaker slider. Both of them are pro style, so let's explore them now. This is the speaker list style 1. Now this is the second style for speaker list. Here is the third style for speaker list. Speaker list 4 style is here. And this is our fifth style for the speaker. Now, if you are an organizer, you also have a style. You can keep your logo, you can keep your email address, social link, and so on. Now, let's explore another slider style for the multiple speakers. So, here is the first slider style for the multiple speaker. This is the second style. Third style is here. Here is the fourth style for the multiple speakers. This is the fifth style for the multiple speakers. As already mentioned, ThemeWinter team is continuously updating their style. So visit us at themewinter.com for more pro style. You can display all this beautiful style in your website with a shortcode, Elementor and Gutenberg block. Now let's explore them one by one. To add with a shortcode, we'll get back to the Eventin, then we'll go for settings. After that, we'll click on shortcode. Here is the list of our shortcode. We have speaker list, schedule list, organizer list, then we have speaker classic list, speaker standard list. Now we also have speakers slider. Did you notice that we have small description for all of our shortcode? Yes, we add this because we do care to our customers more than the others do. Now let's see how the shortcode works in live page. In order to see how a shortcode works, we'll just copy and paste it in a new page. But before moving to the new page, I would like to share something more. If you notice in your dashboard, there is no organizer list, speaker classic list, speaker standard list or similar kind of pro features. Don't be afraid. You will get all this pro shortcode when you will update your WP Eventin in pro version. Now let's see how the shortcode works. So I'll go to new page. Now I'll paste the shortcode here. You see, you need to have speakers category. To get speakers category, we'll get back to the WP Eventin dashboard again, then speakers categories, then we have ID3 for the speakers. So we'll copy it, we'll paste it to the shortcode. Now you can change something more from the shortcode, like speakers count, show designation and so on. Now let's publish it. Let's see how it looks in live page. Our speakers is working absolutely fine. Now let's move to the next options, how we can edit this page with the Elementor. So we will first click on the edit page. After that, we'll click again edit with the Elementor. After that, you will get all the widgets under the Eventin event. Now let's explore one live example. For that, we'll just drag and drop Eventin Speakers Pro to the page. Now you can change the style from the drop down menu. You also have other customization options like speakers count, speaker column, order speaker by and so on. After customizing as like as you want, you can update it and let's see how it looks in live page. Our speakers widgets is working absolutely fine. Now the last options, let's explore how Gutenberg block works with the WP Eventin. In order to do that, we'll get back again to our WordPress dashboard, then we'll go with a new page. Here, if you search with the speaker, you will get the speaker list. So just click on it and the speaker list will pop down in your page. Now if you customize these things, you can customize with here, style 1 and style 2 is available here. After that, you can customize the count, you can customize column and many more things. Now let's publish it. Let's see how it looks in live page. Absolutely fine. It's looking nice in our site.